Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. We are discussing sequence and series, and this is lecture number 5. I hope you have already watched part 1 to part 4 before watching this part 5. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about arithmetic mean. What is arithmetic mean? And how to insert arithmetic mean between the given numbers. So here, arithmetic mean, the topic is arithmetic mean. Arithmetic mean. In short, it is called AM. A stand for arithmetic, M for mean. So if A and B be any two number, A and B be any two number, then an A be the arithmetic mean between A and B, then A and B are in AP, right? This implies second term, because A is mean means in between. So second term minus first term must be equal to third term minus second term. This implies 2A is equal to A plus B. A will come this side, it will be positive, A will come this side. And therefore, A is equal to A plus B by 2. This is arithmetic mean between two number. That is, arithmetic mean between two numbers is A plus B by 2. Sum of these two divided by 2. Okay, I hope you got it. Now, there are some other questions. Insert an arithmetic mean n AMs between two given numbers. Between two given numbers A and B. Numbers A and B. How to insert an arithmetic mean? So we can write here. This is a topic. We will write here, let A1, A2, A3 up to An be an arithmetic means between A and B. An arithmetic means between A and B. And therefore, A1, A2, A3 up to An and B are in AP, right? Here the total number of terms is n plus 2, because there are AP, n AMs and 2 of the numbers, where B is given Tn plus 2th term, and therefore Tn plus 2th term is B. So applying the formula, A plus n plus 2 minus 1 into T is equal to B. And therefore, here A plus n plus 1 into T is equal to B. And this implies D can be written as B minus A upon n plus 1. Remember this. Now A1, A2, A3. A1 is what? A1 is second term, that is A plus D, and therefore B minus A upon N plus 1 into A. That will be AN plus A plus B minus A upon N plus 1. So here A and A cancel, that will be AN plus B upon N plus 1. Similarly, you can calculate A2, and if you will calculate A2, that will be A plus 2D, right? So A plus 2 times of B minus A upon N plus 1. So that will be again, it will be AN plus A plus 2B minus 2A whole divided by N plus 1. And that will come up here, that AN minus 1 plus 2b upon n plus 1. So the coefficient of n is going to decrease and coefficient of b is going to increase. This is the pattern. And similarly, if you calculate an, that will be n plus nb, and that will be a plus n times of b minus a upon n plus 1. So it will be like n plus 1. So that will be a plus nb upon n plus 1. I hope you got it, all these. And now the question is, let us solve some questions. And question is given here, question number 13. 14 is there, 13 we had discussed. Insert 5 arithmetic mean between 8 and 26. Insert 5 AMs, 5 numbers between 8 and 24, between 8 and 26, such that the inserting sequence is in AP. The resulting sequence is an AP. Okay, means you have to insert 5 numbers. So we can write solutions like, let A1, A2, A3, A4, A5 are 5 numbers between 8 and 26. 8 and 26. So what will happen? This 8, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, and 26 are in AP, right now? So what will happen? These are in AP, and that is how many terms are there? 5 to 7. So here T7 is 26, A is 8. So using the formula, T7 is equal to A plus 6D, isn't it? 27 is equal to 8 plus 6D. So 26 was there. Sorry, 26. This was 26. So 26 is equal to 6D is equal to 18, and therefore D is equal to 3. So D is 3. Now A1 is just second term. So second term is A plus D. A1 is 8 plus D. That is 8 plus 3 is 11. A2 is 8 plus 2D. That is 8 plus 2 into 3. That is 14. A3 will be A plus 3D, A plus 4D, and therefore the sequence will come like A3 is 8 plus 3D, that is 8 plus 3 into 3, that is 9 plus 8, 17. A4 is 8 plus 4D, that is 8 plus 3 into 4, that is 12, 20, and A5 are 8 plus 5D, that is 8 plus 5 into 3, that is 15 plus 8, 23. So these are the 5 numbers, and therefore 5 numbers are 11, 14, 17, 20, and 23. That will be answered. So hopefully you got this. Okay, now the next question is here, question number 15. And question number 15, they say, if an plus bn divided by a to the power n minus 1 plus b to the power n minus 1 is the am between a and b, find the value of n. Between a and b, find the value of n. Find the value of n. So solution can be here, like we know n between 2, a and B are two numbers, then AM is what? A plus B by 2. Arithmetic mean is A plus B by 2. And therefore, using this fact, because both of them represent the arithmetic mean, so A to the power n minus 1, A to the power n plus B to the power n, that can be written as A to the power n plus B to the power n divided by A to the power n minus 1 plus B to the power n minus 1 is equal to A plus B by 2, isn't it? This implies this will be 2A to the power n plus 2B to the power n is equal to this multiply. What will happen? A plus B into A to the power n minus 1 plus B to the power n minus 1. So that will be 2A to the power n plus 2B to the power n is equal to A multiply by A to the power n minus 1 is A to the power n plus AB to the power n minus 1. Similarly, multiply by B A to the power n minus 1 plus B to the power n. Now, if I would subtract this A to the power n this side, since 2A to the power n minus A to the power n, A to the power n, 2B to the power n minus B to the power n, B to the power n, so B to the power n minus AB to the power, or is equal to AB to the power n minus 1 plus BA to the power n minus 1. We can write here A to the power n minus AB to the power n minus 1 or is equal to BA to the power n minus 1 minus B to the power n. What will happen then? I can take common here A. A can be taken common. So what is left here? A to the power n minus 1 minus B to the power n minus 1. If I will take common here B, then what will be happen? A to the power n minus 1 minus B to the power n minus 1. I can take common from these two. So here A minus A into A to the power n B to the power n minus 1 minus A to the power n minus 1 minus B to the power n minus 1 is equal to 0. So if I will take here A minus B will left, and A to the power n minus 1 minus B to the power n minus 1 is equal to 0. Since A is not equal to B, so A minus B cannot be 0. And therefore, A minus B cannot be 0. And in that case, A to the power n minus 1 minus B to the power n minus 1 is equal to 0. And therefore, A to the power n minus 1 is equal to B to the power n minus 1. That can be written as A by B whole to the power n minus 1 is equal to 1. The same can be written as A to the power n minus 1 is equal to A to the power A by B to the power 0. 1 can be written like this. And therefore, n minus 1 is 0 and n is equal to 1. That is the answer. This is the solution. Otherwise, it can be observed easily for objective questions that you need here A only instead of A to the power n. So, n must be 1. Then only it will come A plus B. Okay. But because this is a question and we have solved it like subjective one. So I hope you got it. Now the next question is between 1 and 31, question number 16. Between 1 and 31, M numbers have been inserted. M numbers have been inserted in such a way that the resulting sequence is in AP, right? And the ratio of seventh and m minus one eighth numbers age 5:9. find the value of m. Find the value of m. This is a question. So here m numbers are inserted. So we can use the same concept. Let you'll write here solutions. Let a1, a2, a3 up to am be m numbers between 1 and 31. So therefore 1, a1, a2, a3 up to am and 31 are in AP. Here m plus 1 2th term is 31 and a1 is 1. So we can write here a plus m plus 2 minus 1 into d. Nth term is a plus n minus 1 to d. That is 31. So this employee we can write 1 is equal to m1 plus m plus 1 into d is equal to 31. 1 plus, right now. So it will be nothing else but m plus 1 into d is equal to 30. M plus 1 into d is equal to 30, and therefore d is equal to 30 upon m plus 1. This is first equation. Now since here this is the first term, this one second term, third term, fourth term, so seventh a7 is a1 is a plus d, a2 is 1 plus 2d, so a7th is 1 plus 7d, that is a plus 7d. So we can write here that is 1 plus 7 times of 30 upon m plus 1, which is equal to m plus 1 plus 210 divided by m plus 1. So seventh number is m plus 1 211 upon m plus 1, right? This is the second one. Am minus 1 is nothing else but we can write here this is m plus 2th term, this is mth term, a minus 1 7th term, a7 is a plus 7 times of d. So this will be 31 minus d will be am, and 31 minus 2d will be am minus 1. So even you can write 31 minus 2d, but that can be written also as a1 plus in the similar way, so that it, you will write it in the similar fashion. So it will be m minus 1 into d is 30 upon m plus 1. In that case, this is m plus 1 plus 30m minus 30 whole divided by m plus 1. Right now? So that will come up here like 31m. 30m plus m is 31m minus 29 upon m plus 1. This is third one. According to question, a7 and amth minus 1 are in ratio. Here given a7, 5 is to 9. So according to question, a7 upon am minus 1 are in ratio 5 is to 9. This employee, a7 is nothing else but m plus 211, m plus 211 upon m plus 1, and here is also m plus 1, so these two can be cancelled out. Minus 29 is equal to 5 by 9, m plus 1 and m plus 1 will cancel out. Now 9 multiply this m, this will be 9m plus 1899 is equal to 155m minus 145. And therefore, this will come this side and it will be 9 will come this side. It will subtract 146m is equal to, that will be sum. So this will be 902044, and therefore m is 2044 divided by 146. That can be cancelled, 146, 1 is 146. and then left 54. 54, 4, 544. So 14, and that will be the answer. So I hope you got this question, how to deal with, right? Now there is one more question, and question number 17 is there. Let me write this question number 17. And 17 is there, that a man starts repaying a loan. It is given that a man starts repaying a loan as first installment is rupees 100. First installment of rupees 100, and if he increases the installment by rupees 5 every month, what amount he will pay in 30th installment. Okay, this is a question. So what to deal with this question? Solution is, he has just started to paying the repayment, like first installment is 100. So A is 100, and he increases by 5 rupees, and you have to 5/30th installment is what. So A30 is A plus 2090. Everybody knows that TN is equal to, using TN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So that will be A is 100 plus 29 into 5, that is 100 plus 145 is equal to 245. That will be the answer right now. So what amount he will pay in 30th installment, that is 245. This is just simple application of arithmetic progression. Now there is a question, and this question is 18. The difference between two consecutive interior angles of a polygon is 5 degrees, right? If the smallest angle is 120 degrees, find the number of sides of polygon. Find the number of sides of polygon. So we know how to deal with these questions. Try to understand solution. We know the sum of all interior angles of a polygon of n sides is 2n minus 4 into 90 degrees, isn't it? Here the given that the angles of polygons are here the angle of polygons are angles of polygons are given by polygons are 120 at smallest, then there will be 125 degrees, then 130 degrees, and so on up to n angles. n angles are there. Therefore, according to question, their sum will be 120 plus 125 plus 130 plus this up to n terms must be equal to 2n minus 4 into 90 degree. Can I write like this? Okay. Now, this will be what? This will be n by 2 using AP, 2 into 120 plus n minus 1 into common difference is 5 is equal to 180 n minus 360. If you multiply by 2, this will be n into 5n and this will be 240 minus 5 is 235 is equal to 360 n minus 720. So that will be here 5n square minus 125n plus 720 is equal to 0. That is n minus n square minus 25n plus 144 is equal to 0. So which will be n is equal to n minus 9, n minus 16 are two factors. But when n is equal to 16, tn is 195, which is greater than 180. So it is not possible, not possible. And what is answer? Answer is n is equal to 9. Therefore, n is 9. This is the answer. Because interior angle cannot be greater than 180 degree. So that's all in this lecture. I hope you understand it. AP is finished. Now, there are some properties as well. We can do that. Property of arithmetic progression, that if you add any number in sequence of an AP, then the resultant sequence will also remain in AP. So by adding a fixed constant in each term of an AP, the sequence will remain in AP. By subtracting each term by a constant, then also it will remain in AP. By multiplying a non-zero constant in each term of sequence of an AP, then it will also remain in AP. And by dividing each term by a non-zero constant, then the sequence will be also in AP. So this is a common thing and that will be applicable in arithmetic progression. And I hope you got it. You will be able to understand this. You will solve some questions in the booklet which is given to you. And if there is any problem in arithmetic progression, you will ask in the next class. Till then, bye-bye. God bless. And in next class, we will start geometric progression. Okay. So, that's all. And don't forget to subscribe this channel and share to your friends as well. Thank you. Thank you very much.